Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to show you how I made this photo slash art ledge for less than $5. If you haven't seen the video from last week where I made these acrylic calendars, you can go ahead and check out that video. But I figured I needed something underneath it to hold all of the markers and my sticky notes and my washi tapes. And since I have, you know, leftover craft supplies, which I don't like lingering around, I figured I whip something up and also share it with you guys. Okay, so first up, I'm going to need some wood for this, and I just picked up some kiln dried wood from Home Depot. This is like one of their cheapest wood that they have available. So this measures to be 2 inches wide and it's 1 inch in diameter. If you have a simple cut, usually at Home Depot they have like little workstations where you can use their saw to just cut it down, or you can actually have the people there cut it down for you. Because this was a pickup order, I figured I might as well just do it myself. Okay, this is totally optional depending on who was cutting your wood. I kind of did a not so great job, so I'm just going to use my sand blocker just to sand down the edges a little bit so that it's nice and smooth. Another quick note is that I already have some drill holes in my wood. You don't actually need these holes. I was originally going to use this for another project, but I decided to scrap that idea, and so it's there now. But so ignore the holes. So for this project, I'm going to use the Gorilla Glue wood glue, and then I'm also going to use some Jenga blocks from the Dollar Tree because I'm obsessed with this stuff. And then also I have some wooden beads that I still have left over from other projects. I'm going to work on the front piece of the ledge here, and what I do is I place a very thin layer of glue onto a Jenga block, and then I use a flat paintbrush to just remove any extra glue that's just kind of seeping through the seams when I attach the Jenga block to the main ledge. And then I take a wood bead and I apply some glue to the bottom of it, and I place it right next to the Jenga block with the hole facing up. Now, I also use the paintbrush to apply some glue on the sides of the Jenga block that is touching the bead. And then I also apply some glue at the bottom of the Jenga block and I lay it down. And once again, I also use the paintbrush to clean up any excess glue. I really do think that like taking the time to just clean up the glue really, really helps, because once that thing dries, like it's gonna be a pain in the butt to remove. And also sanding it down might mess up with the whole look. So I just went ahead and just took my time with it. And then I repeat this until I finish the length of the ledge. For me, once I got to the end, I did have one Jenga block kind of sticking over the ledge a little bit because it was longer than the ledge, so I just took a saw and I just kind of trimmed it down. Okay, so next up, I'm going to use 5 Jenga blocks for the backing of the ledge, and that's going to be what is going to mount to the back of the wall. So on the 5 Jenga blocks, on one end, I marked out a hole that is 1/2 inch in, and then on the other end, I marked out a hole that is 3/8 inch in. And then using the smallest drill bit I have, I drill through each one of the holes. And then switching to a larger drill bit, I went ahead and drilled through that same pilot hole as well. Because the Jenga blocks are kind of small, I didn't want to immediately use a big drill bit because it might split the Jenga blocks. And creating the holes helped me figure out where I want to attach it onto the ledge and also how I want to mount the ledge to the wall. I went ahead and I repeat this on the other 4 Jenga blocks as well. Okay, so here's the front of the ledge, just very simple, very boho and chic. And then if I flip it to the back, this is where I'm going to add the other 5 Jenga blocks. I went ahead and I marked out the 5 spots where I want the 5 Jenga blocks to be. Okay, so this is a little hard to see, but hopefully I can explain it well enough. So the end where the hole is 3/8 inch away from the end, that's the one that's going to be attached to the ledge. I just use a simple number 8 wood screw and I just screw that to the ledge. And then I went ahead and attached the other 4 Jenga blocks to the ledge as well. Okay, so now it's time to hang this thing, and it's actually pretty easy. I used 5 Jenga blocks for the back, so that means I'm going to need 5 more screws. So what I did was I actually figured out the height of where I want the ledge to be, and then I screwed in the very middle screw of the ledge. And then I take my leveler and I place it right on top of the ledge, and I make sure that it's nice and straight. And I went ahead and screwed in the 2 ends, and then the last 2 screws after that. So this is what the final product looks like. Fairly simple, very easy to accomplish. To be fairly honest, I think the width of my ledge is a little bit too narrow. The store-bought ones can be around 3 to 4 inches in width so that you can really tilt your art or your photo back. I'm okay with this because I'm only using it to hold my markers and other small necessities. But if you're really going to be layering art and photos, I would go for a wider piece of wood. So this next bit here is completely optional, but I'm going to share it with you anyways in case you're interested. I'm using cup hooks here and I'm just screwing it to the bottom of the ledge on both ends. And then I just have this wooden dowel in my craft room that I haven't used for anything, so I figured I'm going to use it to hold my washi tape. And so I just pop it right onto the cup hooks, and then at the end I glued it on some wood beads. And because I'm using cup hooks, the dowel is still removable, so if I ever need to add more to my washi collection, I can easily do so. And then I just use the washi tape to stick it to my laminated cardstock, which I would write little notes on. I don't necessarily use sticky notes anymore since it is a waste of paper, and I figured this is a little bit better for the environment, and it's cute because it matches with my decor. And another fun little quirky bit, I did mention to glue the beads with the hole facing upwards. Obviously, you can glue it with the holes facing side to side to cover it up, but I wanted the holes upwards because I wanted to be able to stick like tiny little plants or little flags or notes or whatnot that I get, you know, every now and then. And it's just something to chipper me up when I have to look at this, you know, to-do wall. And that's it, my super simple and easy art ledge that didn't take too many power tools to accomplish. I hope you guys liked the video. If you do, let me know down below. And also, if you're going to try this out, please share with me a photo on Instagram. I would love to check it out, and I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye!